This video is brought to you by NordVPN, an award-winning VPN service that lets you browse the web from anywhere in the world, protecting you from being logged, targeted with ads, and keeping those bad guys at bay and away from your data. Head to nordvpn.com/technob to learn more, and stay tuned to the end of the video for a very special offer. We can argue about it all day in the comments, but the Pixel 2 XL, the iPhone X, and the S9 Plus are what most people would think of as the best smartphones out right now. But Huawei wants you to reconsider that list. The P20 Pro is here to be a contender for your flagship phone of choice, and also the one sitting in your pocket. It seemingly has it all: a crazy fast processor, lots of RAM, a beautiful design, and a camera that DxOMark literally calls a game changer. But for a price tag of about $1,000, it drives a hard bargain and costs a pretty penny, but maybe it's worth it. Maybe. I'm Robert Rosenfeld of Techno Buffalo, and let's see if the P20 Pro can really take on the best of the best. The first literally glaring thing about this phone is its color. Huawei calls it Twilight, and it sticks out like a sore thumb in this flagship lineup. It seems to garner some mixed reactions. Some love the mirror finish, others hate the fingerprints and the smudges it easily attracts, and after using it for about a week, I'd have to say I am in the latter group of thinking. Huawei does offer this phone in a variety of other color options, and the rest of the phone is built really well, as it should be for this price. It feels comfortable to hold in the hand, it feels premium, and thanks to those rounded edges, it's not too slippery either. Let's move on to the massive 6.1-inch AMOLED display, coming in at a resolution of 2240 by 1080. It is absolutely beautiful, and everything displayed on it looks super sharp and clear. Putting it side by side with other flagships of its price, you can see the P20 Pro can really hold its own with the best of the best. Whether you're watching movies, browsing the web, or scrolling through photos, it's all gonna look really good on this display, which also, just worth mentioning, gets fairly bright, up to 770 nits if you're comparing spec sheet for spec sheet. And sitting at the top of that display, it's hard to ignore, it's a notch. And the whole idea of notches on Android phones is a topic for a whole separate video, but I will say this: if you don't like the notch, you can easily turn it off in software, and thanks to that AMOLED display, you won't really even notice it was there to begin with. I personally don't mind it, in fact, I kinda like it, and it does serve a good purpose on this phone. Inside of that notch is a 24 megapixel selfie camera that is used for the insanely fast face unlocking. Now, I know John mentioned this in our other video, the initial unboxing we did of this phone, but man, oh man, is this thing fast. It's as fast as Face ID, but because it skips the lock screen and goes right to the home screen after authenticating, it seems even faster. That's not to say it's as secure as Face ID, but I will say I was unable to fool it during my testing period. The same goes for the fingerprint reader right below the screen. It's very fast and just small enough to be there, but not big enough to be in the way. The specs on this phone are just as impressive. It's got 6 gigs of RAM, 128 gigs of internal storage, an octa-core Kirin 970 processor, and it's running Android 8.1 on top of Huawei's EMUI, which brings a lot of little extra goodies and features to the software. There's not a whole lot to say about performance. The phone ran extremely well throughout my testing and could easily handle high-end games, multitasking with no problem at all. But let's get to the star of the show, the whole reason why most of you guys are probably interested in this phone and watching this video, and that is the camera. So let me attempt to break this all down. The P20 Pro has a 3-camera system on the back of this phone that's made up of a 20 megapixel monochrome sensor with an f1.6 aperture, a whopping 40 megapixel sensor, and an 8 megapixel sensor f2.4 with a telephoto lens. On a spec sheet, this camera setup sounds crazy impressive, and it very much is. The P20 Pro is currently the number one phone on DxOMark, receiving a score of 109. And just for some context, that is 10 points higher than the S9 Plus and 12 points higher than the iPhone X. But the real question needs to be asked: is it really that good? The answer to this question is kind of a mixed bag, but let me explain. First things first, this phone has a pro photo mode on it that has enough options and settings to make any mobile shooting pro very happy. By default, the phone is going to shoot 10 megapixel stills using all the sensor data from the 40 megapixel sensor plus the monochrome sensor data to combine it together to give you a higher quality image with a smaller file size. If you start pixel peeping, you can see the P20 Pro's camera can retain a lot more detail and clarity than other flagship shooters. Going into a fully manual mode will allow you to overwrite all these settings and shoot true 40 megapixel stills if you wish. The phone really shines in dark environments as well. Low light photos are able to retain a lot more detail and possess a lot less noise than what I've seen done on other phones. I am in no way a smartphone camera connoisseur. I'll occasionally dabble in pro mode, but most of the time I'm looking to get the best shot possible in the shortest amount of time and in the easiest way, which usually means I'm shooting in fully auto mode. And when that is the case, I found I could take better photos more quickly on other phones. Here's a photo from the P20 Pro stacked against the Pixel 2 XL and the iPhone 10. You can see the P20 Pro does not take a bad photo at all, but you may find it less favorable to the photos from the other phones. My point is that if you're looking to snap a quick picture, share it, and it's gonna look really good, you're probably gonna be happier with a Samsung, Pixel, or iPhone than you will with the P20 Pro. Also, I do need to mention that Huawei is aggressively pushing their AI system in many aspects of this phone, and they certainly are very much pushing it when it comes to the camera. And it doesn't really work all that well, especially in all auto mode. The AI will attempt to adjust your photo to make it look better for the specific subject you're shooting, but 90% of the time, it just made things look a lot worse, and it made the photo look very overprocessed. You can of course turn this off in settings, but I really tried to let the AI do its thing, but most of the time, I just came away disappointed. On the video side, the phone shoots 4K, though it's gonna be without any stabilization. It's only gonna be available in 1080p, but if you are shooting video in 1080p, you'll get both optical and AI stabilization. There's also a super slow motion mode that competes with the S9, shooting at 960 frames per second. It's honestly a party trick. It does a fair job, but you're probably not gonna use it that much. Moving on to a few other things worth mentioning, battery life on this phone is very, very good. It's packed inside with a 4,000 milliamp hour battery, and I was easily able to make it through an entire day and charge it at night, not worrying about that battery draining too fast. It is worth mentioning that there is no wireless charging. You'll have to rely on that good old USB-C cable, and no, there is no headphone jack. Without a headphone jack, you can use a pair of wireless headphones or the phone's built-in speakers to listen to content, which are just okay. They're gonna get fairly loud, but high quality and high fidelity is not super important to Huawei in this phone. Also worth mentioning, this phone is very expensive. It's priced overseas at 900 euros, over 1100 US dollars. This phone is expensive no matter where you live, but if you're in the US and decide to import it, be aware it will work with GSM providers only, like T-Mobile and AT&T, and it's not officially supported, so there may be features and bands that just do not work here in the States. Just keep that in mind. So let's wrap this all up. Despite some government investigations into Huawei here in the US, the P20 Pro is a flagship contender that kind of seemed to come out of nowhere. There's no doubt about it. It's a powerful phone with a solid screen and a great battery to back it all up. But I'm still just kind of hung up on the camera. If you love to tinker with settings and get the absolute most out of the camera in your pocket, then you're probably gonna love the P20 Pro. But if you're looking for the best and easiest to use camera out there, you'll most likely prefer any of the other flagships currently on the market. For a price that puts this phone at the top tier of even the highest end smartphones, I'd make sure you're really ready to jump ship to a first of its kind phone that lacks even some of the most basic of things like wireless charging. If you can live without that and you just want the bleeding edge of mobile phone camera technology, then I say go for it. And if you're going to go for it and live on the bleeding edge of technology, you are definitely going to want to protect yourself when you're browsing on your phone, your tablet, your computer, basically all of your devices. Maybe there's that one coffee shop down the street that has super fast Wi-Fi and you like to go there to check your email, browse the web, chat with friends, maybe even a little bit of online shopping. But remember that every time you connect without a VPN, you're putting a target on your back. This goes for any public Wi-Fi. It could be a coffee shop, a hotel, an airport. Basically, anytime you jump onto one of these public Wi-Fi networks, you're putting yourself and your data at risk of intrusion from hackers, keyloggers, man-in-the-middle attacks. Basically, you are an open target for any snooper looking to get your information. If you want to keep your connection online safe, check out our sponsor NordVPN, a state-of-the-art VPN service that keeps your connection private, fast, and most importantly, very secure. NordVPN offers legitimate military-grade encryption of your internet traffic that will keep you from being logged, traced, and targeted with ads. You'll be able to surf the web from anywhere in the world without worrying about your security or your data, and your connection will be very fast. You'll automatically connect to one of NordVPN's thousands of servers across 61 countries that removes any bottleneck or any slowdown. And I'm just as guilty as everybody else. I often jump on a public hotspot for a few minutes to get some information or check my email, but it's always kind of bothered me. And from now on, I don't have to worry. I know in full confidence, using NordVPN, my connection is secure and my data is safe. Don't put this off any longer. Don't wait anymore. Start browsing the web safely and securely today. Head to nordvpn.com/technob and sign up. They're offering 77% off a 3-year plan, which is a fantastic deal. And if you want to learn more, click that link down below. And thanks again to NordVPN for sponsoring this video. So what are your thoughts on Huawei's newest flagship contender? Is the triple camera setup enticing enough to get you to jump ship over, or is the notch just a big turnoff? Leave your comment down below. Let us know. Also, be on the lookout for one of the most requested versus videos of all time. It's the Pixel 2 XL going head to head with the S9 Plus. It's a battle of all battles, and John will declare a winner. That video is coming soon, so be sure to stay on the lookout for that. I am Robert Rosenfeld with Techno Buffalo. Thanks so much for watching this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.